And in animals in homes, apartments, or other buildings has skyrocketed. Metro Animal Services says it's coincided with the tough economy. Ann Bowden joins us now with one case that has particularly upset many in the Highlands. Ann?
Well, Rick, animal abandonment happens quite often in Louisville when residents are evicted. They have to foreclose or move because finances have been cut. But too many times, as you're about to see, pets are being left behind.
We've treated him with supportive care for a week, and he hasn't improved as much as we would like. He's still unable to stand. He still has pretty severe tremors.
Erin Jewell is a veterinary technician at Farley Pet Center in the Highlands. She wasn't prepared for this patient.
Well, I was at work last Tuesday, July 1st, and one of the receptionists came to the back to get me because I'm one of the head techs and said that somebody had walked in and found a dog abandoned in an apartment.
Jewel says the cleaning crew of a Highlands apartment complex found the boxer in an apartment that had been vacated for days. Starved, dehydrated, and in poor condition, care needed to be immediate.
And when I saw the dog's condition, I just could not send him out the door, so I took legal financial responsibility for the dog.
As a vet, she set out to save the boxer she named Cracker Jack. Oh,
yeah. You know, when he was eating, he would eat everything you would give to him.
And in an apartment with no food or water, he found other objects to eat.
Well, we thought he had a big foreign body or a mass inside of his belly. He's so thin that you can palpate his belly.
It was a towel.
Found a little piece of a towel, so just gently pulled it out. And I was like, well, you know, he ate a towel.
He presents like a dog who had potentially gotten into something. That was the first thing that came to my mind.
Specialists at the Metropolitan Veterinary Specialist Center are also involved. These tremors could be from a toxin, genetic condition, malnutrition, or worse, distemper, although that's unlikely. These animal specialists say they understand financial hardships, even foreclosures, but this didn't have to happen.
There are avenues that you can take. No Kill Louisville has a food bank. They help people. All the shelters will take any animal in and try to help them and rehome them.
As for Cracker Jack, everyone is hoping for the best.
Overall, I feel optimistic that hopefully this won't be fatal.
And he definitely has the will to live.
Now, the vet says Cracker Jack looks like he's a puppy, but that may not be the case. Other features show that he actually may be a young adult boxer that is stunted in growth developmentally. But so far, his blood work is good and he's alert and he has a desire to play, which is a good sign. But as you heard the vet saying, only time will tell. Live in the newsroom, Ann Bowden, WLKY News.
I wanna leave my footprints on the sands of time. No, there was something that meant something that I left behind. When I leave this world, I'll leave no regrets. Leave something to remember so they won't forget I was here. Something in somebody.
your life in ways no one has ever done before. They love a little stronger, they live to give their best, they make our lives so blessed. Why do they go so soon, the ones who are so, so beautiful? I heard someone say there must be borrowed angels here in this life. They come along into this world and make this world bright. They can't stay forever, 'cause they're heaven sent, and sometimes heaven needs them back again. Never let them go. The world's a little richer just 'cause they came along. Their love goes on and on. So why do they go so soon, the ones with souls so beautiful? I heard someone say there must be
No, you're something else. You really are.
Yes, I love you, Boo Boo.